We've been running this service now, the 24/7 primary angioplasty, for about 16 months. So a number of studies, national studies, the most important one being the myocardial infarct national audit project, MINAP, has clearly demonstrated that the most efficient way of providing this service, providing an angioplasty service on a 24-hour basis, is for the patient to be delivered directly to the cath lab. So bypassing all other potential sites like the coronary care unit, like the emergency department, and this would minimize the delay in getting the patient's artery opened. What we're trying to achieve is to get the patient to us, to the cath lab, as soon as possible. And for the patients who are delivered directly to the cath lab, over the past year, we have had fantastic door to balloon times. The patient took the ideal pathway, which we would like all patients with suspected heart attacks to take, and be brought directly to the cath lab. So this patient was delivered directly to the ambulance entrance, and the paramedics who had diagnosed the heart attack brought the patient directly to the cath lab, having pre-alerted us prior to that. So we were all ready to receive the patient. His ECG clearly demonstrated that his inferior wall, the undersurface of the heart, was in trouble, with most likely culprit being the right coronary artery being occluded. He was having an inferior ST elevation myocardial infarction.
Let's have the sheath, please, sir. Go with the JL35, look at the left first, and then we'll go with the bobber guide. A little pressure in the wrist. Now you're going to feel a hot flush in the arm. That will wear off in a few seconds.
The first priority is to gain arterial access. In this unit, a vast majority of us go through the wrist to the radial artery, and from there we pass tubes all the way up the arm, up to the aorta, and into the coronary arteries to take pictures of the arteries and confirm which artery it is that is occluded.
Okay, just sitting there. Ready? And there is where the problem is. As you can see in the middle, the right coronary artery is subtotally occluded with very poor flow in the distal vessel. So let's have a pilot 50 wire, please.
And the priority is to get that artery open as soon as possible and minimize the duration of ischemia, the period where the heart is starved of oxygen and blood.
Good. Go up there. Six, eight, 10, 12. Down you come. That's the 12. Balloon going up within the artery to release the blockage and restore flow to the distal vessel.
And once we've done that by sucking out the thrombus with a thrombectomy catheter and ballooned to restore blood flow to the distal artery, then we scaffold the artery with a stent to maintain the artery open and prevent it from reclosing in the days and weeks ahead.
Now we're going to put a metal stent in the artery to keep it open and allow blood flow to the distal artery. Test that, please. Twist in. Okay. 38. So
3538.
Well, I think the procedure today was really a tribute to the whole team. From the moment the diagnosis was made at the patient's home by the paramedics, they very speedily brought the patient to us. The whole team here was ready and prepared, and everything went extremely smoothly. Very successful case. The patient had minimal duration of ischemia. The door to balloon time, I think, was somewhere in the region of 20 minutes. And it really is a tribute to the team. the team did fantastically well, and the patient should do very well indeed.
That looks good. Clear cranium. So the artery is nice and open. Your pain should all settle down now.
Okay. Most of our ambulance crew are familiar with diagnosing MIs in the community, and many were delivering pre-hospital thrombolysis before we started providing a 24/7 service. So continue with the fantastic work that you've been doing. Diagnose the heart attack in the community, have confidence, and as soon as you have a patient with a suspected MI, just call us, send a message, tell us that you're bringing in the MI, and deliver the patient directly to the cath lab. Many of these patients will have complications, many of them will have complications of their MI, so arrhythmias, they may even arrest en route. What I would like you all to remember is that the best place to deal with all those complications is the cath lab, and the best treatment is to open that occluded artery.